Hello and welcome to the December edition of Your News. My name is Joyce Anderson. We have a look at some of the big summer events. We have an update on day services and the new Militon Cafe. First, we look back to the summer events.
Many of our customers from across the city was there to welcome home the Paralympians. And the beautiful Octopus Club kept with the theme of the Olympics, and this is what they turned out. A few days of good weather this summer, it looked as though the picnic in the park might never happen. However, we managed to slip it in between days of torrential rain when, despite a less than promising start to the day, the rain finally held off for long enough. Breaking news. The new building at Rothwell Fulfilling Lives has been approved. The design proposals have been shared with the customers and carers and staff and other stakeholders. There's been good feedback and it's all been passed on to the architects. We are delighted to confirm that the funding has been secured and the council's executive board has given its backing to the project. It has now got full steam ahead and obtained planning permission to enable construction work to begin in summer 2013 and the work to be scheduled to be completed in early 2014. Middleton Park Cafe opened on Monday the 10th of December. The cafe will be run Monday to Friday by our service and will provide training and paid employment for some customers who will be supported by staff. Friends of Middleton Park will operate the cafe at weekends. During the week the cafe will be open from 10:15 in the morning till 2:15 in the afternoon. So why not go along and give them your support?
Coming up at the end of this programme, we will discover who is the winner of this year's Christmas card design.
Church Lane held a spooky Pink Friday in aid of breast cancer and managed to raise over £250. Potter Newton also held a Pink Day and everybody got in the spirit of things and they managed to raise over £350 on the day. Customers from Rossfield Lawn went on a day trip to Scarborough. The weather was fantastic and they packed a lot into the day. They went boating at Pizone Park and fed the fish at the Sea Life Centre and went onto the amusement arcades on the seafront. Sounds like they packed a lot into a great day. Meanwhile, customers at Delph View had fun planning the holiday of their dreams. They collected pictures of different things to do with holidays, such as weather, transport, time of the year, accommodation, location, food, and entertainment. Then they made a poster of what would be their perfect holiday, whilst eating snacks and listening to holiday music. This year saw the launch of the Get Me campaign. Its mission is to challenge perceptions and understanding of people with learning disabilities.
Is it fair to say that your favourite thing is going out and meeting new people?
And we'd like to say a big thank you to some customers who got involved in the recruitment of new staff this year. We'd like to say thank you to Claire and Deirdre, who interviewed in August, and also a big thank you to Stanley Levin and Victoria Ward.
Not to forget the up and coming events over the next few months.
Yeah, keep your eyes peeled over the next few months because the Ice Cube will be returning to Leeds, and we always have the special, usually on Thursday, so check it out a little bit later on in the next month or so. And also, don't forget the great Leeds Valentine's Fair, bigger and better than ever. Christmas is also a time to remember absent friends, and it is with sadness that we need to report the recent deaths of two much loved and respected colleagues, Paula Coltus, who died following a long illness, and Mandy Knight, who died very suddenly. Our thoughts are with their families and friends at this sad time, and with the customers and colleagues of South Parkway, where both Paula and Mandy worked. Mandy's family would like to thank everyone who contributed to the collection, which raised £900 for the British Heart Foundation and LGI's neurology ward. Now it's time to reveal the winner of this year's Christmas card competition. Over 150 designs were entered in this year's competition. Cards were painted, coloured, sprinkled with glitter. An amazing variety of materials were used to decorate the pictures, including newspaper, photographs, tinsel and tissue paper. First place in the East Northeast went to Gail Keating. And first place in West Northwest went to Shelley Winship. First place in South Southeast went to Stephen Eleanor. But the overall winner, I will let Andy reveal.
The prize, and we'll also have the Christmas cards, which I'll show you in a bit, but the winner of the prize is, if you can remember the picture of this, is Shelley Winship.
Much mistletoeing and hearts will be glowing when loved ones are near. It's the most wonderful time.
Helen Chapman, customers and staff based at our community base at Pudsey Leisure Centre, swam the channel recently. Everyone swam 23 lengths of the Pudsey Baths each week for 10 weeks, which added together made 21 miles in distance. The swimmers hope to raise over £300 for people with mental health issues or who are homeless. Linda Tate and Teresa Jardine, who both work at the Horsforth Fulfilling Life Service, won the Adult Social Care Staff Award for Excellence in the category of Working as a Team for Leeds. And Sandra Wilson, a carer who works at the Changing Place shop based in Bramley Fulfilling Life Service, who won the Personal Achiever category. Also, Leon Carey, who was nominated by a customer for his hard work in the Right Choices Awards for Excellence, Leon received a certificate for £50, which he donated to charity.
I am Joy Sanderson, and thanks for watching your December news.